Third Sunday, a day of special prayer for priestly, religious, and missionary vocations. The image of the Good Shepherd has been used since the early times of the Church to express Jesus' tenderness and love for all of us. We honor and thank, first of all, Jesus, who laid down his life for the salvation of all human beings. We also thank and pray for the junior good shepherds who were chosen and sent by Jesus himself to minister to our spiritual needs. Let us pray at this Eucharistic celebration that many more may heed the invitation of Jesus and respond to it with generous faithfulness.
Can you rise for the entrance hymn?
Bounding the hills, see how our God has come to meet us. His voice is lifted, his face is joy. Now is the season to sing a song on high. Come then, O Lord of glory, show us your face. Speak, for we know your words are love. Leaping the mountains, bounding the hills, see how our God has come to meet us. His voice is lifted, this is joy. Now is the season to sing a song on high.
Let us offer this Mass for the intention of our parishioners. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear friend, Jesus Christ, as we heard in the introduction, today the fourth Sunday of Easter, and today is also the Good Shepherd Sunday, where we pray for all the religious, the priests, those who are priests, nuns, and those on missionaries who have left home and gone far and wide to proclaim the good news, who have experienced Jesus as a good shepherd. And the good shepherd knows what is good for the sheep, and he takes care of the sheep. And ultimately, we are in his fold. We are the flock of this good shepherd, and we have been taken care of by our Lord Jesus Christ. Hence, we don't have to worry about that. And Saint Peter speaks in the first reading that his name is so powerful, by his name we can receive salvation and we all will be saved. Let us remain in this faith and experience God's love and ask pardon from the Lord for the time we have accepted our Jesus as a good shepherd in our life. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
Kindly join us in the Lord have mercy.
Have mercy on us, sinners, Lord. Have mercy on us. implore you, Lord, have mercy on us. We fail to be the roots of unity. Have mercy, O Lord. We fail to build a happy family. Have mercy, O Lord. Have mercy on us sinners, Lord. Have mercy on us. Have mercy, implore you, Lord. Have mercy on us.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Kindly join us in the Gloria.
Let us pray. Almighty ever living God, lead us to share in the joys of heaven, so that humble flock may reach where the brave shepherd has gone before. Lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In those days, Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said to them, "Rulers of the people and elders,
If we are being tested today, considering a good deed done to a crippled man, by what means this man has been healed? Let it be known to all of you and to all the people of Israel that by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead, by him this man is standing before you well. This Jesus is a stone that was rejected by man, the builders which you become the cornerstone, and there is salvation in no one else. For there is no other name under heaven given among men by which we must be saved. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Kindly join us in the responsorial psalm.
The builders rejected has become the cornerstone. The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. Oh, thank the Lord, for he is good. His love lasts for all time. Sing hallelujah. The builders rejected has become the cornerstone. You are my Savior and my God. You yearn and answer me. I trust in you alone. Hallelujah. The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. Stone which once was set aside is now the cornerstone. All now will it arise. Hallelujah. The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone.
A reading from the first letter of Saint John. Beloved, see what kind of love the Father has given to us, that we should be called children of God, and so we are. The reason why the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now, and what we will be has not yet appeared. But we know that when he appears, we shall be like him, because we shall see him as he is. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Kindly rise for the gospel.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, give thanks to the risen Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, give praise to his name. Jesus is Lord of all the earth. He is the King of creation. Hallelujah, hallelujah, give thanks to
the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. He who is hired hand and not a shepherd, who does not own the sheep, sees a wolf coming and leaves the sheep and flees. And the wolf snatches them and scatters them. He flees because he is a hired hand and cares nothing for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my own and my own know me. Just as the Father knows me and I know the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep. And I have other sheep that are not of this fold. I must bring them also, and they will listen to my voice. So they will be one flock, one shepherd. For this reason, the Father loves me, because I lay down my life that I may take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down for my own accord. I have authority to lay it down, and I have authority to take it up again. This charge I have received from my Father. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear friend, Jesus Christ, we are in Easter season. And how many of them can say that we are really experiencing the risen Lord? We are called that we are Easter people, and Alleluia is our song. But the present scenario makes us that we are pandemic people, lockdown people, and COVID-19 is our song. My dear friends, this Easter season has a different meaning or different aspect in our life. On the Easter Sunday, we experience the risen Lord. Jesus is risen for us, and he rose from the death, victory over death, and he came into life so that we may all live and enter into the kingdom of God. On the second Sunday of Easter, we have the Divine Mercy Sunday. We experience a merciful Father, the merciful God, who had great mercy towards us. Last Sunday, the third Sunday of Easter, Jesus said, "Peace be with you." This greeting he gives us so that we all may remain in that peace, a serene life, a happy life, so that we may always trust in him and always experience his love and affection. And today we are on the fourth Sunday of Easter, the Good Shepherd Sunday. And Jesus himself says that, "I am the Good Shepherd, and I know my sheep, and my sheep knows me. And I have laid down my life for my sheep." Yes, my dear friend, Jesus Christ, we have this Easter experience, and we are experiencing this Easter season in a different light. Looking at this pandemic scenario, sometimes we feel, where are we? Where are we leading? We also have this doubt on our faith. Looking at our faith, do we really say that Jesus is our Savior, Jesus is our Redeemer, Jesus is our Healer? Are we really have that faith and we constantly say that Jesus is for us? My dear friends, faith makes all things possible, but it is not easy. Faith makes all things possible, but it is not easy. And that is what we have experiencing during this Easter season, where Jesus is risen for us. He is the light of the world. And today in the gospel, we can identify three things. One is the identity of Christ. The second, unity of Jesus with God Father. And the third is the connectivity of God the Father, Jesus, and we, the people of God. It's my dear friend, Jesus Christ, that Jesus said, "I am the good shepherd." And in the John's gospel, from the chapter 1 till the end, you will find that Jesus time and again says that, "I am he. I am the bread of life. I am the living bread. I am the light of the world. I am the door. I am the gate. And I am the resurrection and the life. I am the way, the truth, and the life. And I am the true vine. Is he proud about himself and saying that I am he, hence you have to be always with me? Rather, he's giving us an assurance that every walk of life, at every aspect of our life, he is present. He's present that I am there with you till the end. And that is assurance he gives us, maybe in time of your difficulty, your problems and worries, I am there. I will be as a light, I will be as a bread, I will be as a life, and you will really be saved from all this. And today in the gospel, Jesus speaks about this two contradiction of shepherd. First, he speaks about the good shepherd. Who is this good shepherd? Good shepherd is one who takes care of his sheep. He knows each and every sheep is in the fold, and he takes care of them. And is ready to give his own life for his sheep. The good shepherd knows the responsibility and takes care of the sheep and protects them. And that is the greatest thing we can see in good shepherd. And today in the scenario, who are the good shepherd? We can see a lot of good shepherds around who are ready to help others, not thinking about their own selves. Look at our own parents who are sacrificing their life and taking care of us. Look at our neighbors who are ready to help us. We have the doctors, the nurses, the health workers who have sacrificed life and taking care of all those people who are coming into the hospital. My dear friend, that we all have to be like the good shepherd to do good to others, to know what is the difficult situation and help them in their need. And the good shepherd knows each and every sheep, and he knows each and every sheep the problem. If there is a good shepherd, there is also the bad shepherd. And Jesus calls this bad shepherd as an hired hand. They do not take care of the sheep, even though they have the sheep with them. But the difficult time when the wolf comes, they run away. They leave the sheep there and they run away to save themselves. They are only worried about their personal worthy, but they are not worried about the other's problem. And hence, Jesus calls them the hired hand, because they do this work as a mere job, a duty. It is not a calling. Rather, shepherding is a calling, my dear friends, by which we look at other people and we serve them and we help them. For this hired hand, for them, there is an illusion of protecting people. But in reality, they don't help anyone. In reality, they don't help. And that's my dear friend, Jesus Christ. Today, Jesus is talking about this identity, that I am the good shepherd and I have laid down my life for my sheep. And hence, we as a Catholic have to look into ourselves and see, as a Catholic, what identity we have. Are we like the good shepherd or are we like the bad shepherd? Are we ready to give our life for others? There are many others today, many in the society or many in the parish also, who are like this good shepherd. When there's need, they are putting messages on the status so that the messages may reach others and people may be saved. There are people who are searching for bed, searching for medicine for others so that they may be saved, just to save others. Yes, my dear friend, Jesus Christ, we have to accept this identity in ourselves, that we are the followers of Christ, and hence our identity should be like the good shepherd. The second thing is unity. I know my own and my own know me. And this is what Jesus says. He knows the Father and the Father knows me. He knows the sheep and the sheep knows the shepherd. Yes, my dear friend, Jesus Christ, good shepherd has laid down his life for his own sheep. And he knows the sheep so well that he solves all the problems of the sheep. And yes, my dear friends, in Jesus Christ, and that is the unity between the Father and the Son, which John's Gospel gives us in a beautiful theme. And in the beginning of the John's Gospel, it says that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And that is the unity with the Father and the Son. And in the second place, he says that Jesus tells the Jewish leaders that I and the Father are one. I and the Father are one. Jesus is ready to accept anyone and everyone in his fold. He knows, he is sure that everyone will listen to his voice and enter into his flock. And he says that there will be one flock and one shepherd, that is Jesus Christ. There may be many barriers in our life which can separate us from each other, which can separate us from our family, which can separate us from our society. And then these barriers has to be removed. This have become a stone in our family. We might be having a lot of stones in our family. We may call our religious articles which is there, or we may have the relationship, the love, the money. Sometimes this becomes a barrier. But rather Jesus says that this barrier has to be removed. And that's what as Saint Peter talks about in the first reading. The builders rejected the stone. The stone with the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. In Psalm 118, we very well sung today. The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. And that stone, the barrier which is there, has to become the cornerstone in your life, my dear friends. And that will join two walls, that will join the relationship, and that will join the love and affection in your own family. And you will find the Lord of happiness is there because this cornerstone is present in our life. And yes, my dear friend, Jesus Christ, do not reject the cornerstone, because the cornerstone is important for us to hold us strong, to keep us firm, to always trust in Him. And the third thing is the connectivity of Father, the Son, and the people of God. And that's what Jesus said, I have received this commandment from my Father. The commandment of authority, the commandment of compassion, the commandment of love. And He has received from His Father. And that's why God the Father sent His only begotten Son into this world so that we all may be saved. And the Son loved us so much that He died on the cross, a shameful death on the cross, so that we may be saved. And we have today the people of God who are ready to sacrifice their life to save us. Yes, my dear friend, Jesus Christ, we have to accept this connectivity of Jesus so that we can share this love and affection to others also. And how are we going to connect ourselves with God, with Jesus? That is through prayer. Prayer is important, my dear friends. You may run behind medicine, you run behind vaccine, or run behind many other things. But ultimately, prayer is important so that we can connect ourselves and receive the grace and share this grace with others so that all may enjoy that. And that is why in the second reading, the first John, letter of John says that God the Father has adopted all of us as His children. We all are children of God. We are adopted one and we are the chosen one. Hence, we are going to experience the Christ. The Christ whom really came down for us as human being, and He lived among us. Christ as a Savior, Christ as a healer, Christ as a good shepherd. And hence, we all have to accept Him and live in His grace. Sometimes God puts us in dark mode of life to show us that He is the light. And this Easter candle, which is brighter, must brighten our life also, so that we can see things clear, we can see Jesus and share this Jesus with others. My dear friend, Jesus Christ, as we are in this lockdown period, let this be our prayer, that let this lockdown may not suffocate us, let this lockdown may not put us down or suppress us. Rather, we rejuvenate with our Lord, the risen Lord. And let this be our prayer, to listen to God's voice and reflect, to obey His word and His teaching, to call out his gospel salvation message, to know what is the purpose of this life which is going on, to dwell in his presence. Do not fear, my dear friends, to offer a prayer for everyone's safety, to wait, to be patient. This too will pass by, to nurture our personal relationship with him. Yes, my dear friend, Jesus Christ, as we are on the fourth Sunday of Easter season, let us experience the Good Shepherd. The Good Shepherd has laid down his life for us. He will strengthen us and resolve us to commit ourselves under the guidance of his love and mercy. And hence, we can remain as a good citizen, a good neighbor, a good family member, and a good child of God, so that we all may experience the Good Shepherd in our life. Amen. Let us profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, only Son, our Lord, was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to hell. On the third day, rose again from the dead. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Prayer of the faithful. We are the flock guided and protected by Jesus, the Good Shepherd, who gave his life for us. Full of confidence in his compassionate love, let us pray to him.
Jesus, Good Shepherd, hear our prayer together.
Jesus, Good Shepherd, hear our prayer.
For all the leaders of the church, the Pope, the bishops, the priests, may they be good shepherds totally devoted to the welfare and eternal salvation of their flock. Let us pray.
Jesus, Good Shepherd, hear our prayer.
For all the lay faithful, may they love their shepherds and experience God's loving care through them. Let us pray.
Jesus, Good Shepherd, hear our prayer.
For all parents, teachers, and other people responsible for others, may they always be conscious of the importance of their role and fulfill it with generous dedication. Let us pray.
Jesus, Good Shepherd, hear our prayer.
For the young Catholics called to the priesthood or the religious life, may they respond generously to the Lord's invitation and devote their lives to the good of God's people. Let us pray.
Jesus, Good Shepherd, hear our prayer.
Let us pray in silence for our personal intentions. Let us pray.
Jesus, Good Shepherd, hear our prayer.
Most loving Jesus, you lay down your life to protect us from the attacks of evil one and to lead us to the pasture of eternal life. Grant that we may be appreciative of the salvation you earn for us. May we always follow you, our divine shepherd, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Spirit.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands
for the praise and glory of His name,
for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these Paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy. We make this prayer to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is a sacrificial victim who dies no more. The Lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers, the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Sing, holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, your glory fills all up and heaven. Sing, Hosanna to God. Blessed is the one who comes from heaven in the name of the Lord. Praise and honor be to God on high. Sing, Hosanna to God. Sing, holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, your glory fills all earth and heaven. Sing, Hosanna to God.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave to disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave to disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks to held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and bread of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Oswald, gracious our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters, the fallen asleep, the hope of the resurrection, and all who died in your mercy, welcome them the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we merit to be coerced in a life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. through him and with him and in him. O God, Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days. And by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress. As we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Like a flute, and I want to play all day. Jesus Christ is my music master. Deep from my heart flows a simple melody. Greatest is love, love without end. Greatest is love, love without end. He's my shepherd, my guide. Dark be the night, Christ is my light. Nothing I fear, Jesus is near. He leads me to the kingdom. My heart's like a flute, and I want to play all day. Jesus Christ is my music master. Deep from my heart flows a simple melody. Great is his love, love without end. Great is his love, love without end.
The Anima Christi. Soul of Christ, sanctify me. Body of Christ, save me. Blood of Christ, inebriate me. Water from Christ's side, wash me. Passion of Christ, strengthen me. O good Jesus, hear me. Within thy wounds, hide me. Suffer me not to be separated from thee. From the malicious enemy, defend me. In the hour of my death, call me, and bid me come unto thee, that I may praise thee with thy saints and with thy angels forever and ever. Amen.
Let us pray. Look upon your flock, kind shepherd, and be pleased to settle in eternal pasture the sheep you have redeemed by the precious blood of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Going to announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My Lord, He died for a kingdom to redeem the heart so full. Now my people, don't you weep, He has risen from His sleep, He lives again. Alleluia, sing alleluia, the Lord is risen, He is risen indeed, alleluia, sing alleluia. Risen indeed, alleluia.